Hello everyone, my name's Thomas and welcome to the island of Sodor, where all my friends and I work really hard on our railways and be really useful engines. Today is Chinese New Year, a holiday that people celebrate in China, and every year the holiday tells us what animal we celebrate for, and this year is the Chinese zodiac, also known as the year of the rabbit. But many years ago, it was the year of the dragon, and I had to take a one that's made out of paper to a carnival, and it scared Percy because he thought it was real. Let me explain the story to you. One morning at the sheds, I was getting ready for my daily job when the fat controller arrived to give me an extra job. He told me to go to the harbor that night to pick up something unusual. I was puzzled about what he wanted me to get and asked him what it was. Wait and see was the only answer he gave me. Meanwhile, Percy was shunting some trucks into a siding and the singleman had to switch the points so Henry could pass by. But when the singleman tried to switch the points back for Percy, the points were jammed, so Percy couldn't go anywhere till morning. He was very cross. When night came, Percy was alone in the dark and he was very scared. Even the noise of an owl didn't help make him comfortable. It let out a loud screeching noise and scared the daylights out of him. I wish Thomas were here too, he sighed. When I was at the harbor, I couldn't wait to see what the unusual thing was. Just then, a crane carefully lifted down a realistic-looking dragon and it caught me off guard. But my driver calmed me down and explained what it was. This dragon is made of paper. It's for the carnival tomorrow. After the workmen loaded the dragon onto the flatbed, they added lights around it as protection so another engine could see me coming and not crash into me. The only thing I wasn't aware of was Percy sleeping at the sidings. When I was passing by, he woke all startled to see the dragon and immediately shut his eyes tight, thinking it was a real dragon that was covered in bright lights. The next morning, the switches were fixed and Percy went to Napford Station and told Gordon what he saw. But Gordon didn't believe him. You've been in the sun for too long, your dome has cracked, and puffed away, leaving Percy frustrated. Soon, the news about the night before spread across the island and the engines started teasing him too. He started to think that maybe he was imagining the dragon when suddenly, I pulled into the station with it and scared the daylights out of him for the second time. Percy was cross with me at first, but then I explained to him about the carnival and he wasn't so mad at me anymore. By the way, how was your night out? Percy decided to tell me the truth and I smiled at him and said, well Percy, maybe we do get scared sometimes, but if we're not afraid to tell each other, then that means we're quite brave too. Percy agreed with me and it was as if nothing happened. And that's the story about Percy thinking he saw something that wasn't really there. Just remember that if you've seen something suspicious or mischievous, make sure you are not seeing things and cause a great deal out of it or else people will think you are going crazy. I better get back to work and continue helping for this year's carnival as well as being a really useful engine. Come back another time so I can tell you another story that happened here on the railways. Happy Chinese New Year and see you real soon.